Everyman Driver Nation, welcome inside the 2016 Mazda 3S five-door Grand Touring. I'm Dave Erickson. Today's video is all about your top three likes and dislikes of this vehicle. I did a review of the automatic version about 9-10 months ago, and then when I got the 2016 manual, I thought, well, there's no point in doing a full detailed review because the only difference is, you know, the automatic versus the manual. So I want to hear your top three likes and dislikes. Plus, the 2017 is already out, and so I'm kind of in between right now. So I've compiled a list from the comments left on YouTube and on Facebook, more than 70 of them, and I've put together a PDF that you can download for free. Just go to my newsletter list on everymandriver.com, sign up for it, and I will send it out on my next email list so you can have a copy and see what everyone has listed as their top three likes and dislikes, and then I'll comment, of course, on my opinion of what you think. So it really turned out to be, number one was the exterior styling. A lot of you really liked the way it looked. One person here says looks more expensive than it actually is. The styling in and out, very aggressive without being in your face like the Veloster. Sporty lines. The styling here says, I think it's the best looking car on the road in its price segment and even above, both inside and out. Styling inside and out, it's beautiful. So people are really liking that, obviously. Body design is bold inside and out. Good balance of sportiness. Nice exterior design. So based on all of the comments, number one was styling. So exterior, the sporty lines, the overall look, that was number one. And I think I might have to agree with that one. Number two was the drive handling and driving dynamics. So here, driving dynamics, this is actually that person's number one. This person says it's not fast, but it's quick. It can easily get up and go, and handling is very nice. Handling, sporty handling, driving experience, available of the manual transmission. This one here says peppy engine, fun to drive. The fact that you can get a manual transmission on the top of the trim lines and not just the base trim lines. So that's pretty impressive. Yeah, definitely handling. It's one of those cars that really fits the driver, kind of hugs the driver on the inside, really decent bolstering on the seats. It responds well. It's a front wheel drive, 2.5 liter inline four cylinder, 184 horses, 185 pound feet of torque. Of course, playing with the six speed manual is a lot of fun too. So yeah, I'm gonna have to agree with number two. The third one here, I think, is the consensus. There were a lot of, some people were submitting, you know, top four, and I said just top three. But top three, rounding out, would be miles per gallon. This one here says achieved well above miles per gallon estimates. After 30,000 miles, I achieved 36.3 miles per gallon with the 2.5 liter. And after 3,000 with the 2 liter, I averaged 38.1. So this person bought two versions of it. This viewer wrote, I get close to 33 miles per gallon and mostly highway driving. Fuel economy, great mileage, great engine balancing and performance with economy. So that was the third most commented like about this vehicle. And here's the estimates, 26 miles per gallon in the city, 35 on the highway. I personally have averaged just over 30. So yes, Mazda is above what their estimates are on the miles per gallon. So those are the majority of the top three likes and dislikes. Other ones were price. Some people like the fact that there was a hatchback with the option, the manual transmission option on the top trim lines. Seat comfort, you know, I mentioned that with the bolstering. That was another one of the popular ones. So there you go. Again, I can give this to you on my email list. Now, we're moving on to the top three dislikes of this vehicle. By the way, I'm inside because it's raining outside and I don't want to get all wet and this isn't really important this time around. Okay, top three dislikes. And this one was top of my list and a lot of lists too, and that's what I'm going with right now, is rear seat, leg room, and headroom. Kind of tight back here, and that's probably the biggest part. Let me go through some of the comments. Rear seat room is a bit tight. Back seat leg room. Rear seat leg room. Back seat space. Rear seat room. Rear seat leg room. Back seat is kind of cramped. So clearly people are not enjoying their back seat, leg room, and headroom. But really that's gonna be a passenger issue, not so much a driver issue. And if you're driving around, I would guess that most of you have two people in the car at one time, but if you are gonna have three, that's what people are saying about the back seat. So that's the number one dislike of the Mazda 3. The second most commented dislike is the 7-inch screen that sits here on the dash. A lot of people were saying the infotainment screen looks tacked on, like an afterthought. And the term afterthought was used quite a bit. Not my terms, not my words. That's what everyone was saying, and it was said a lot. So afterthought. This viewer wrote, weird location of display in the upper dash. Looks like an afterthought. The infotainment screen still looks like a complete and total afterthought that was tacked onto the dash. And the menu system along jog dial is to access it is unintuitive and clunky. Is that a word? Unintuitive? Not intuitive. And I'll just add this on to this topic here of number two, is the fact there's no Android Auto or Apple CarPlay in the 2016. So that was mentioned and scattered throughout the comments as well. So I'll just add it to the infotainment system, how that screen sits up here, the fact there's no Android Auto or Apple CarPlay. And the third most mentioned dislike of the Mazda 3 was road noise. Road noise is a big issue, and I have some in-depth comments here. Okay, this is a dislike. The interior, all of it, followed up by, it's loud at freeway speeds. This person wrote, road noise, hope to change the stock tires soon on their vehicle. So this person has a Mazda 3 and does complain about road noise. I'm gonna throw in here a bonus dislike, only because it was a close third. It was fourth, but it was close to third, and that was the rear hatch. This one says here, the old 3 hatch was a wonder cargo storage capability. The new hatch comes in the rear glass at a weird angle, preventing larger objects from being placed in the cargo area behind the seats. The cargo opening also pinches in more at the top, making larger square-shaped objects having difficulty fitting into the cargo opening. This person says there's no automatic trunk opening system. True, true, and true. Appreciate your comments. If you'd like a copy of the PDF of everybody's comments that I compiled, you can go to everymandriver.com and sign up for our newsletter, and I will send that out here in about a week. That way everyone has a chance to watch this video and comment on it. So just kind of recap some of the general comments. Here were all the pluses. Looks, the styling, the ride and handling, driving dynamics, the seats, these were pluses. The engine with the manual transmission option, miles per gallon. Price point, I didn't mention the price point, sorry about that. Price point on this is just about $26,000. And some people did like the hatchback as an option. Negatives, recapping, rear seat legroom and headroom, the road noise, the screen here on the dash, the rear hatch size for cargo volume, and no Android Auto or Apple CarPlay. So there you go. Be sure to follow me on Facebook and on Instagram. I'm doing a lot of updates that are exclusive to Facebook, on Facebook, video updates. So like my page there. In fact, it wasn't that long ago, I gave you a complete list of all the vehicles I'll be driving from now until December. So check it out, explore it, leave comments there, and I thank you very much. Until next time, I'm Dave Erickson with Everyman Driver. Thanks for watching. Adios.